Hello guys, in this video let's see about the Samsung Galaxy A50's 5 month review. So I have been using this phone for around 5 months as my secondary device and I am really feeling happy with it. But I face several issues nowadays after getting the recent update and I have to surely tell you about that. And mainly it's the battery. And see, the fingerprint sensor is quite faster nowadays. When I bought this device first time, I didn't feel the fingerprint sensor was much faster even from the Vivo's V11 Pro. But nowadays it is competing with the OnePlus device itself because of the recent update. And also I have registered my same finger 3 times, so that's make it quite faster than the before one itself. But the recent updates actually drain its battery as fast as possible. This phone hosts a 4000 mAh battery, should comparably bring you up to 1.5 days of usage, but this phone is not even handling a 1 day full usage, so I have to charge it twice to get it powered for a day. So as a basic device, you couldn't use it without a charger or a power bank for just having a 4000 mAh battery behind. Why this device is draining much faster? I really doubted my always on applications, but it seems that's not legit. The truth is, this phone's update or the UI is actually consuming a lot of battery and the battery management is really poor in the recent update. I wish in future security patches with that we can get that update and fix the battery life also. The other thing is the camera is really good. The camera update means that they have gave some kind of development towards detailing, of course, and the light reproduction of lighting is also really great after the update. And the camera for a selfie and also the rear camera and the wide angle camera is really great nowadays compared to the earlier versions. This camera app is really great, but they didn't still upgrade the 4K video capability. But if you want to record 4K using Samsung Galaxy A50, means you can go and install a Google camera app that supports 4K video recording, as the Exynos 9610 has a support for 4K 30 video recording. The other things as concerned, the audio quality is also getting much poorer because I use a flagship device and behind that I use this basic mid-range smartphone. I should get some kind of decent audio quality. But the audio quality from Samsung Galaxy A50 is okay, it can be used. It's not unusable, but still the high frequency response is really poor and the loudness is extremely good. So that's the thing according to the sound quality from the device I could expect. From the headphone jack, you really get a decent level of audio through the headphone jack without any kind of issues. But still, you need to get some improvement towards the audio quality from the loudspeaker itself. And also from the earpiece, the audio quality is really decent, not up to the level of flagship devices like Samsung Galaxy's S10 or Note 10 or LG V30, LG V40, those flagship devices or even iPhones. You can't compare with them. Comparing with the mid-range available in the Chinese markets, still the A50's earpiece and the loudspeaker performance is much more better, but needs to get some improvement so that it can perform much more better. The software capabilities are still really great. They have updated to the July 1 security patches, so we don't want anything. For at least up to September, they will be giving some kind of security patches. So the last update was held last month, and you can see the software is still on Android Pie. You can also expect 10 for this device, as this is not a very old device. This phone came up with Android 9 as a stock, so we also can expect Android 11. Oh, I don't know what to mention about the Android 11, but Android 10 you can also expect. Android Q can be expected by the end of this year or in the Q1 of 2020, but still it performs well. The navigation is also really great. I love this kind of navigation because all the phones with Android 9 has this navigation system. I have noted it twice in all my friends' smartphones, but still the navigation in A50 is much more better because it's much more accurate. Coming up with the in-display fingerprint sensor again, I can really perform, you can see how fast it is in certain times because, oops, so I will show you later. So some kind of issues like that's for some things will actually case the in-display fingerprint sensor out working. So to make it work, your finger should be not much more wet, should be dry, so it works now fine. So there are several issues in the in-display fingerprint sensor, but still it is much more faster because I have set up all the three fingerprints as my own single thumb only. So it's much more faster than the earlier ones, which I said one for this thumb and the right thumb and any other finger, that worked pretty slower than this technique itself. And for this I have installed a Poco launcher, so you could see the launcher is totally different. Don't worry about it, Poco launcher is really great for this phone. It gives me some kind of OnePlus ish device, because they also has a similar launcher. The Oxygen OS also has a similar theme, so I just kept the launcher alone as Poco launcher. I don't like the theme that OneUI gave me. I had to go and search like this. For this I can just search the type of applications and just access them much more easier compared to the earlier ones. So I really love Poco launcher, so I'll just leave the link in the description. You can go and get and download it. It's really great. And also I have to change some settings to get the pure dark view. The other problems I actually faced in this phone is also burn-in issues. Oh my god, just around 3 to 4 months, within 3 to 4 months of usage, that also basic secondary device usage, I got some kind of burn-in issues. So as I said, I faced some kind of burn-in issues in the A50 because they have used AMOLED display. Earlier I used Samsung Galaxy A8 Plus, I used lots of Samsung devices, even their flagship Note 3, S7 Edge. These phones, they didn't give me such a kind of result, because I love to only use black wallpapers. So I just used a wallpaper with the Neversettle logo. Recently I got some kind of burn-in issues, and I actually opened any app, I could see the Neversettle burn-ins. But that actually a first stage burn-in, so that I didn't get the permanent mark inside. But if you are using super bright vivid wallpapers all the time, you will surely get burn-in issues that are permanently marked, that will actually harm your display. So don't ever use super high vivid wallpapers. Setting the brightness to the full 100% brightness always, even in the dark time. So if you are doing like this, means you are going to have some kind of issues in the future. So if you are going to use a smartphone at least for a year, please go and switch to the dark mode and also the wallpapers also. Because I also use dark mode because I don't like that white and blue tint while using an AMOLED display. If I am using an IPS panel, I have to set colorful wallpapers and also white theme itself instead of black. But I have this A50 has AMOLED display, so individual pixels are lit by themselves, not like the backlit one. So make sure you care about the display also. Don't use stock wallpapers that are bright and vivid. If you use like that, you may get some burning issues in future. So that was the only issue I faced with the A50. Even in A8 Plus I didn't get such a result of burn-in, but in A50 I got it. So I don't know whether the display quality is much more poor or something, but still the viewing angles and image qualities, that visual qualities are really stunning only. So I don't get such kind of issues, but I got burn-in issue a single time, and so that only I just used some kind of color fixing tool to actually get rid of those dead pixels and active them. The pixels are not actually mentioned, as the burn-in will be not taking place as pixel, instead it will be taking place as a dots. Like RGB, we got RGB, a pixel contains three dots. So in that I got some red dots dimmed by itself, so that only I got that burn-in issue. When I actually just test them with image tester, I could see that all these lights, like the red, green, blue and the grayscale, were fine after some testing process alone. So make sure to do switch to the dark wallpaper and also to the dark mode if you are using an AMOLED display from Samsung. The other issues to be known, the battery issues, and also this kind of single stage burn-in only, the only issue I faced in this 5 months. Other things are really fine, the audio quality via headphone jack and the Dolby Atmos sound is okay. And also the selfie camera and the rear camera are doing its job really nice. And also the physical overview, like the thickness and the holding and using this is not actually a very big device compared to the OnePlus devices or something. It's really compact, not much compact like what the LG V30, the flagship phone that I use as primary device, gives me, but still not as big as OnePlus or A70 that Samsung released recently. But okay, you can also use this phone if you are going to use as a normal day-to-day driver. Other things like other applications works fine. This is actually a 4 gigabit RAM variant. Still it works well and fine in RAM management also. But the only thing is the battery life should be concerned in the update. Next update is really poor. Even not coming up with 1 day of full usage, having 4000 mAh of battery. My 1.5 years old flagship LG V30 does have only 3300 mAh battery and still has a super high resolution display than this one, but still can take up to 1.5 days in a single charge, while this new beast can't even take in 1 day in a full charge. So that's not a good symptoms of using a mid-range phone. So this is not a cheap phone. I didn't buy this phone for 10,000 or something. We have bought this for around 20,000 to 22,000 rupees. So it should do its job for at least 1.5 years. So then only it is a good, the branding of Samsung should do its job well. Otherwise you can also go for Chinese brands like Vivo, Oppo. They are also bringing some competition. Then a final thing I have to tell is, if you are going to buy A50 now, that means the August of 2019, they have lots of selections. Like you can go for Realme X, you can go for S1, Vivo S1, or Vivo Z1 Pro. So those phones are really there for the competition. But if you are really kind of branding, just seeing the branding of Samsung, you really want the Samsung branding and also the branded smartphone, then you can go for A50 now also, because it's really good phone. But the only thing is, in Realme X you will be having a full screen, and also Redmi K20 is there for the competition. Just putting 2000 higher, you will be getting a full screen display with a pop-up camera and also some better performing processor. Finally, I have to tell you one thing. The Exynos 9610 is a really great processor. I really love it because it has lots of processing than compared to the flagship of Snapdragon processors. Like you can compare Snapdragon 835 or 845 in kind of processing with this processor. But the graphics performance is not as good as even the Samsung Snapdragon 710, Qualcomm Snapdragon 710. But actually the graphical performance is also comparable to the Snapdragon 675 that is present in the Redmi Note 7 Pro and also in the Samsung Galaxy A70. So the graphical performance and also the CPU performance is also really great, but the thing is, they have to optimize some battery in the software side itself. Other things is, you are going to get up to September, you will be getting the security patches regularly, but after that you will be getting it twice a month or twice a year or something. You will be getting the security patches. You will also get the Android Q update for sure. So we can just wait for the One UI 2.0 to be launched. And these are the things I really feel with the Samsung Galaxy A50. You feel any kind of issues with any kind of physical hardware or software, please mention that in the comment section, so it will be much more easier for me to clarify those things. So thanks for watching, guys, and this video was not taken in a mobile phone, it's actually taken in a camera. Yes, this is the first video that I captured using a camera. It's the Fujifilm XT100, my new professional camera. So earlier videos have been taken only with the smartphones of my flagship phone or something, but this video is captured first week. This is the first video that I have used my XT100. The sound is being recorded in the XT100 only, because of my microphone doesn't work much well with the camera. So next videos and upcoming videos will be done in a high quality video, and also audio will be also in concern. So make sure to subscribe my channel for getting regular updates. Thanks for watching. See you later on.